Today, I'm going to be reviewing our second to last adventure in the quadrilogy until their upcoming fifth movie, Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade. An art collector appeals to Jones to embark on a search for the Holy Grail. He learns that another archaeologist has disappeared while searching for the precious goblet. And the missing man is his own father, Dr. Henry Jones. Played by Sean Connery from the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. Check out my review if you want, although this movie came out first. Anyways, the artifact is much harder to find than they expected. And its powers are too much for those impure in heart. Sounds like an adventure of a lifetime to me. First off, the visual and practical effects have amped up a whole lot, and I mean improved. I mean, there are parts of this film that do require green screen, and that's not a bad thing at all. But I'm just saying, for other parts of this film, like for example, you see someone literally crying underneath a moving vehicle on set. That's not CG, ladies and gentlemen. That's real stunts, real dirt. Some Uncharted-esque action, if I do say so myself. Man, Spielberg's got some intense mad skills in his massive noggin of his. Well thought out there, man. The camera work and cinematography also gets a plus as well. The action sequences were really thrilling and fun to watch. It's the type of action where I cannot keep my eyes off the screen or even go to the bathroom either. That's how much I enjoyed this movie. The performance was phenomenal. I love the father-son chemistry between Harrison Ford and Sean Connery. They're a thrilling pair to watch. Their back and forth banter between the two connect well off of each other. Especially in dangerous, tough, and painful situations portrayed in this movie, they connect well off of each other nonetheless. Same with the execution and character development and articulation. It still feels like you're on this quest to find the most valuable artifact and stop the bad guys from taking the treasure for themselves, which was done a million times before. It's nothing new in terms of story and plotline. You guys know this. But still, that doesn't make it a terrible movie either. What makes it fun is the wit, charm, care, and energy to the story and characters. And you know what, guys? As a result of all that, I enjoyed the heck out of this film a lot. In the end, to shorten up this review, Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade was a thrilling conclusion to the main trilogy. I had fun with these classics. They're really a hoot to enjoy, trust me. Now, I heard some mixed reactions on our next Indiana Jones film, The Kingdom of the Crystal Skull, but it does look really cool to me, so stay tuned for that review soon. But in the meantime, I rate The Last Crusade 5 out of 5 stars. Believe me, I like Raiders more, but I still think this Indiana Jones film is impressive as well. Give it a try, you might enjoy it as much as me. So The Last Crusade, have you seen it? If you haven't, please give it a watch. It's such a classic. But if you have, come back and let me know in the comments what you thought about it. Also, if you liked this video and you want to see some more, make sure that like button shines in your face. That'll totally help me out a ton. Also, share that video with your family and friends and favorite it. That's a very good way to show support for this review. Also, if you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe and ring that bell right next to you so you can be notified of future videos that I have in store for you. And also, follow me on Stardust so you can catch early reactions to movies, TV shows, and trailers. I'll put the link of it below in the description so you can download the app for yourself. But until then, I'll see you next time. Peace out.